So Blender can be an intimidating software, especially when you're a game dev and have a lot of things going on already to create your game. But once you know the basics, there's a ton you can do to speed things up and make better game assets. Here are some Blender tips I wish I knew sooner. Let's start this off with a simple but crucial one. Triangulate your game assets. If you don't do it in Blender, the game engine will do it for you. But there's two ways to triangulate a quad, and this might affect your materials and animation if it's not done before. So you're better off doing it in Blender to make sure it's triangulated the way you want it to be. You can simply add a triangulate modifier to your object, this way you won't even notice it. Otherwise, if you select all the faces in edit mode and press Ctrl T, it will triangulate them. You can also triangulate when exporting by checking the box in the export settings. Always Ctrl A to apply scale and rotation. It makes sure things like modifiers work as expected and that your UV unwraps aren't distorted. Now, this applies for most situations, but rigs and animated characters might not like it if you apply scale and rotations, so be cautious. Always start your project with proper scale. One Blender unit equals 1 meter, which matches most game engines. So a male character might be around 2 Blender units, and then you can keep that character around when making game assets to use as a reference. You can also look at real dimensions for the game object you're creating and use them. The origin in Blender will be the pivot point in your game engine, so make sure it's placed carefully. Most of the time you want it where the floor will be, so that the game asset sits properly. If it's an asset that will rotate, place the origin at the rotation point. Using the 3D cursor to set the origin is fast and will make manipulation easier in the game engine. Go into edit mode, select a vertex that feels like a good pivot point, press Shift S to load the snap menu and choose cursor to selected. This will put your 3D cursor directly on your selected vertex. Now go back to object mode, right click your mesh, go to set origin and choose origin to 3D cursor. The origin is now set to your desired location. Be careful, some modifiers are using the origin point, so if you move it, it might alter your model. Presets is the way to go when you make different types of assets, like static game objects and animated characters. Making presets for each type of asset will save you a lot of time and prevent you from making mistakes by going through every option every time. You can even take it a step further and make presets for each game engine that you use. If you want more details about export settings, I have a video that goes through all of them for Unity, Unreal Engine, and Godot. Check it out! The Auto Mirror add-on included in Blender makes mirroring fast and easy. It will automatically cut the object, add the mirror modifier, and set things up based on the settings you chose. This is perfect for symmetric models, and it will double the space you can use for your texture since only half the model needs to be unwrapped. The UV grid is one of the most useful tips to UV unwrap efficiently. When it's time to UV unwrap your object, add the Blender UV grid or UV color image texture to make it easy for you to see if your model texture is stretched. It will help you know where to add seams to get a clean texture. You can find the UV grid by creating a new image in the Image Editor panel under the Generated Type option. Here you can select the UV grid or the UV color. Now create a new material and add the image to an Image Texture node. Don't forget to select Material Preview to see it. Combining UVs can be very efficient for small or low detailed assets. You can combine them into a single UV map to optimize your game. Fewer materials mean fewer draw calls, which will get you better game performance. My last tip is only for the baller game devs. It's called UV Packmaster, and it's a fantastic paid add-on. It will make sure your UV islands are efficiently packed, so you can have more detailed textures or have multiple assets on one UV map. The add-on deserves its own video since it's so dense with features. Let me know in the comments if you have any other tips you want to share. I hope this video was useful to you. Take a moment to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching. See ya.